Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for joining me for our art class today. I want to say a special hello to all of our TLC students. Thank you so much for tuning in, and also to all friends and families and, you know, everyone who is, you know, being a part of the show today. So my name is Nicole Georges Bennett, and I will be your paint guide. I always like to say that Teacher Joan and I are guides. We are not professional artists, but we do have a love for the Lord, and we have a love for art, and we like to share our passion with all of you. So just want to say thank you for choosing to join me today, and hopefully you will enjoy what we've got on the menu, so to speak. So today we're going to be painting a chapel. And I believe that this was inspired by, I want to say her name is Ginger Cooks. And she's a YouTube artist, so you can always look her up. And she's got some great painting projects for beginners. So what I've got here is sort of inspired by her painting of a chapel. And I thought it would be nice for us to try this, because on the TLC Arts and Skills Ministry, we haven't actually done this as yet. So what we are going to do is start off with our devotional today. And although we usually do try to find devotionals that relate to our painting, what I have is more loosely associated with our chapel painting today, but it is about being in fellowship with those of like mind and like spirit. So that's what we're going to be reading about today. Psalms 67 and verse 4 says, "Let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you judge the peoples with equity and guide the nations upon the earth." Dear Lord, I'm so grateful to live among those who have enjoyed a heritage of knowing your word, of hearing your gospel, and of acknowledging you as God. Times may be changing, but I ask that you would cause my heart to remain steadfastly devoted to you. I'm going to read that again. Times may be changing, but I ask that you would cause my heart to remain steadfastly devoted to you. Keep my children, grandchildren in your ways, and draw to yourself the hearts of those who have become lost in following other things other than you. Strengthen your people as they follow you, and may they be beacons of your light to those who dwell in darkness. Faithful people have always lived this way. They take care of their home and family, participate in society and government, raise children, and have occupations. All the while, they realize that they, like their ancestors, are temporary residents of a foreign land. And that came from Faith Alone, a Daily Devotional by Martin Luther. Very prominent name in Christendom. So I hope that even though this devotional was very short, that it spoke to your heart, because we are indeed blessed, those of us who are able to freely worship. Maybe you're in a country where that's not so simple and not so easy, and it could actually be a dangerous thing to speak the name of Christ. And we who have that freedom have to remember that we are doubly blessed, because not only do we have our church family, but we have the freedom to worship the Lord. So let's keep them in mind as we paint our chapel and think about the assembling of the brethren and what our fellowship means to us, and just what a gift it is to be surrounded by people who also want to praise and worship the Lord. So our predominant color today for our chapel is going to be blue, and we're going to start off with sort of a darker shade of blue, and then we'll work in some lighter highlights. So I'm thinking probably what we should do is probably start a bit on our sky. Yeah, we can start on our sky. And our sky is also going to be blue, but it's going to be a very light shade. So I'm going to go for more of a turquoise color for the sky. So we'll be looking at a mix of blue, white, and just a dash of yellow, just a touch of yellow. not too much yellow, not, you know, yellow and blue makes a green, and you don't want that. You can hear my music. So you're going to mix your blue and white together. I'm going for a very, very light shade of blue because our chapel is also going to be blue. And you want it to still be able to stand out a bit. And to that, I'm going to add just a touch of yellow. And we're just going to paint around So some of you may have a tree in this corner, so just remember not to paint over your outline for where your tree is. I hope you were able to, those of you in the TLC class, that you were able to get the sketch that I sent to you. That you're able to get it done. It doesn't have to look exactly like mine because everybody's painting is going to look different. It's just to give you sort of a rough idea as to what your chapel should look like. tree right here, so I'm trying not to cover it over fully. If your sketch maybe might have been a little too dark and you can see your tree, then you can paint over it. But I know I'll lose mine if I paint over it fully. Good. So we've more or less got our sky laid in there. We add some little clouds, you know, just kind of add a bit of interest. So then what we're going to do next is we are going to start putting in our color here on our chapel. And as I mentioned, we are going for a deeper shade of blue, but we're going to come back over that with some lighter highlights. So what I'd like you to do is to probably use the same shade of blue that you did for the sky, but hopefully you added some white and yellow to the sky so that you have a different tone and a different shade. And now you can go back to your blue color, the original. You don't even have to clean off your brush because it's all blue. And we're just going to lay in our base color. Thank you. I'm just dabbing my brush like this because I just wanted this to have sort of a different look rather than just sort of straight brush stroke. So you can, of course, just paint, you know, vertically or horizontally as you like. I'm just trying something a little bit different because what I'm looking for with this is not so much architectural accuracy, but more of a feel and a mood to this painting. I'm looking to create the idea that this chapel has been out in the woods for a very long time and that it's well loved, it's weathered by the elements, that sort of thing. So that's kind of what I'm aiming for here. We are going to have to let some of these layers dry as well, because we're going to be sort of building up the idea that there's layers of paint, of old paint, and that we'll hopefully get a very interesting effect. Okay, we're going to move to the front of our chapel, or the front that's facing us, and to that we're going to add just a little bit of the light blue, in which case you just mix the same blue color you're using with white if you don't have light blue. That's just because this is where the light is going to be hitting, so it's going to be a lighter shade than what's in the shadow, right? So I am not 100% sure about getting this as a straight line, so I'm gonna use, you can use a ruler. I'm just gonna use what I got here. So under here, we're going to do draw a slightly darker blue line. Again, you can use your ruler to do that. I'm just going to use my little styrofoam thingy here. We're also going to come up here and we're going to paint around our cross. Or if you don't have a cross, that's fine. You don't have to do exactly what I do. We all want our paintings to have our authentic stamp on them, right? We want them to look like we created them. So there are other elements and things that you want to do with your painting, that's fine. If you would like to maybe not make it blue, even, you know, if you want to make it a little green chapel or a little white chapel, that is perfectly fine. I encourage you to do that. Step out, do your own thing. For our roof, we're going to do the roof slightly darker, so we're going to add a teeny tiny touch of black. And for the class, I know, sorry, I didn't include that color in our palette for today, but I just sort of decided right now that that's what we're going to go with. To give it a bit more atmosphere. So I'm actually just mixing the same shade of blue with just this little touch of black. break up my handy ruler again. This is just for the roof. So we're going to let that dry as well. We're going to come back to a bit more of our blue, and we're going to color in our little steeple area here. And I think we can go with an even lighter shade of blue. So I'm actually going to add a touch of white to my blue. Am I going to do that? Probably not. No, I think I'm actually going to go darker. So I'm going to add a touch more black to the blue mix that I just painted this little steeple area in. It's not like gonna be like a pure black, it's just more like a blue gray. A touch more blue to that, because this is the section that will be facing the sun, so you don't want it to be pure as dark as this. You want it a bit lighter. Thank you. Now, we're not quite finished with roofs. We still have this little section to do here. I'm going to add a little touch more blue so that it stands out just a little bit from this, hopefully. The other places we're going to add some blue to are inside this window, so we're just going to color right into, you notice that there's a bit of a design that I've got going here, so we will just color in the sort of, I'm not sure what shape that is, but right in here in the windows. And we're going to go for the slightly darker blue on that. But we'll probably start off with this gray, sort of gray color first. We're going to go back to our original shade of blue, and we're just going to color in our roof. Thank you. while we let this first layer dry, we're going to start putting in some color in our landscape. So let's start off with our trees. So we're going to put in the initial brown for our trees. Our trees and the backdrop are not going to get as much attention because we're kind of focusing on our chapel. We want that to stand out. I'm just zooming out a little bit so you can see better. So yeah, let's get some brown and we're going to just block out our trees here. I'm just drawing some little extra branches here. That's where we'll have some of our greenery grow that will disguise part of our roof here. And we have another tree over in this corner as well. Make that tree a slightly different shade of brown if you like. You can mix a bit of yellow to it or green, you know, just to, or maybe even make it like a birch tree, which would be sort of gray to white. This might pose a bit of a challenge. It does to me for sure. But I really like the concept here, the idea of the little church tucked away, hidden in the woods. You know, that little place of respite and oasis of peace for the people who live in the environs in this forest. And this is where they come to worship. So we can also do a wooden door. I'm just going to add a touch of yellow to it just to kind of give it a slightly different tone. Or you can do a red door if you like, or even a yellow door. There is one part I forgot to do, and that is the little archway doorway here. So we do have to go back to our blue and finish that off. Some of you probably spotted it already, say, what about that part? Yeah, sorry. All right, so we're going to let that dry. In the meantime, we're going to start filling in some of our grounds here. And for that, you can use different shades of green. You can decide whether or not you want to have like some little bushes. And you could just use your roundhead brush just to do sort of like little bushes. And you can have sort of like various shades of green. We're not going to be very exact with, you know, working out every little blade of grass, but we just want to give the impression that this, there is greenery here. So I'm going to switch to a darker shade of green. And I will probably use that for the foreground here. And just to show you what I mean, take off the excess and just here I've got sort of like this huge sort of flowering bush, I guess. So I don't really have a plan, I'm just sort of putting, and now I'm going to use a brighter shade of green, and again this is just about layering and just adding some different shades and tones, and same thing. And I'm using a big brush, but you can use a smaller brush, and that will also give you sort of a different effect as well. I got a little too much on my brush, but I'm just going to fill it in here. You can also do some dabbing on for your leaves, your foliage here. little bit of a bass here. And then we're going to add in some lighter tones. For that, I'm just going to add a touch of yellow to this shade of green that we've been using. And you can also add a touch of white if you'd like to make that even a bit brighter. For the purposes of time, I'm just going to kind of come back in here, just add in some. And again, this is just sort of, you're just sort of indicating that there's greenery here. And then I'm going to go back to that deep green, and I'm going to recreate that border because it got a little covered over. So that's the darkest shade of green I have here. Just going to add back in some of that color original. It's almost like it's a border around this little field here. So here's where we come to one of those portions where, like I said, you can add in your own little touches. So what I'm planning to do that will make mine distinct is from what she did, and what I hope that you will, you know, try something else yourself. You don't necessarily have to follow what I'm doing, but I'm going to just sort of add in a large leafy plant right in this corner. And let's see how that works out. So this brush is a little too big. I had something else planned, but I think in the interest of time, I'm just gonna work that back a little bit. I'm just creating a bush here that's kind of partially concealing this plant. Over here in the bottom, we've got some steps. Okay, so I just paused for a moment just to let my camera get some juice, and now we're back. In the meantime, what I've done is I have painted the rim of this window with this sort of book kind of design. I guess it's almost like a semicircle shape here. I've outlined this in yellow. There's like a little decorative piece right here. I've covered that in yellow, and I've also done the cross in yellow, and the doorknob is in yellow. What I've also done is I just went back over and added a few more brush dabs with my round paintbrush just to get a bit more depth so that you can see more of the different shades of green in the grass and the foliage here. And I've also just underlined these eaves, I guess you would call them, with a little extra black paint just so that they pop a bit more. And so that's it. So I'll give you a chance to catch up. So just remember, you want to take some paint, some yellow, and just outline this shape right here. Get the little window shape circle at the top there. Also your cross, your doorknob. And in the meantime, while you're doing that, I'm going to add a bit more grass. I'm just going to add some darker tones right here. And to get that tone, I'm just going to add a bit of black to green. So go ahead, finish up. And then when you're all done that, then we shall do some more work on our chapel and we'll be finished. Okay, so I think that should give you enough time. So what we're going to do now is we're going to come back in with our lighter shade of blue. And we're going to sort of create a little bit of dimension in our blue here. So I'm just going to come back in here. And over that texture that we've had before, now I'm just doing this normal brush strokes. Just adding some more tone, saturation rather, to our blue chapel. And then for this side, we're going to add the slightly darker blue. So I'm actually just mixing the darker blue with the light blue that we just used. Add a little bit of dimension here as well. And to that, we're going to add a touch of white, and we'll be almost finished here. Okay, guys, so what I've done is I've stepped out of the frame so that you can get a proper shot. And you'll notice that I've added a few flowers. So I just used my small round brush and I just dabbed with a little bit of blue, a little bit of pink. So which is where the red paint that I advised you to have comes in handy. You just mix that with a bit of white and you've got your pink. And I just did some quick dabs along our field in front of our chapel just to add a bit of color. And I've also rimmed the roof. I think that's called the eaves. I'm not 100% sure. Just gonna try and get a shot here for you. So rimmed it with a bit of white, as you can see. And also the little design in the window also gave it a little touch of white, and that's just to imply that light is hitting there. But other than that, we are all done. So I just want to say thank you so much for joining me, and I hope that you enjoyed this chapel. If you have never tried like a church building or a chapel building before in your painting, this is a nice, easy way to get it started. And I hope that it inspires you to continue on with your paint journey, and also to continue to appreciate the brethren and the congregation that you're in, and the fellowship that you have with brothers and sisters in Christ. All right, that's it, everybody. Have a wonderful day, and God bless your week. Thank you. Take care now.